This is PTC Pat from the Netherlands, and of course, this will be the Tron case soon. We're going to start in a little bit. For now, I'm going to show what you can do if somebody else has your private keys of your wallet. I'm doing great, my man. I hope you're also. Let me share my screen. As the wallet that is compromised is of a friend of mine, we are going to make a new wallet for her. And that wallet is going to be the boss. That wallet is going to be the boss of her wallet. How are we going to do that? Well, first, let us send 101 TRX to that wallet. I hope you're also doing great, Festus. So, of course, this is for Miriam. 1 second, let me tell her. Oh, wait, let me not do that because I just sent her the private keys. Oof, this was just in time. I'm doing great, Festus. Okay, guys, then we're going to, the wallet has just been activated. Then we're going to go down. Why? Let me first prepare everything before I send the money again. Why? The scammer is stealing her funds. So if I send the money there and the scammer is faster than me, I lose my funds. And that is not how it's supposed to be, as I'm trying to help her. Let me first set things up here. Of course, what we're going to do is we're going to go to the Tron blockchain directly. Why? As we're going to set the account. You can see we can change owner access. You can see that the wallet is correct. That means that her wallet is compromised, but the person that stole her private, that stole her funds, does not know how to lock a wallet. For Miriam's case, thank God he only steal her funds and she can still reclaim her wallet as she has invested in multiple programs. We quickly sent 101 TRX to the wallet. We copy our address. Oh, be so quick, Pat. Okay, we copy her. Oh, we scroll down. I'm helping so many people. It's such a long way that I'm scrolling down. We're going to refresh. What we're going to do, guys, now quickly, we are going to edit the access. We are going to change the threshold to 4. We're going to add a new access. Oh, I'm entering. We're going to put a plus here. We're going to put this newly made wallet address, and we're going to put threshold 3. And then we're going to save. Are you sure you want to do this? Signed successfully. Boom. Miriam, your funds are safe of your first wallet. You gave 2 private keys. You gave a backup key and a private key of your other wallet. I fixed your first wallet. Your first wallet has a boss. That means your wallet cannot be emptied anymore. Yo, crypto 1505. Woop, woop. As you can see, I just made sure the wallet that was hacked cannot be stolen anymore. Let me show you guys. Let's say the hacker is now going to use Miriam her wallet. Let's say you can see it like this. There's 1 TRX in it. And let's say the hacker says, ha 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 ha, this 5 cent is mine. He will send it. And now the other wallet is getting a message. Are you sure you want to send this transaction? Are you sure you want to send your money to that? Are you sure you want to withdraw from a smart contract? The other wallet I have just created now is the boss of this wallet. Miriam's money is safe again. Team PTC Pet, we protect you against hackers and scammers. Hoo-ha! Okay, I'm sorry. As you can see, the funds are not coming in. And as you can see, we go back to the wallet. Confirming. The transaction is being confirmed. No, it's not. Why not? Because I am not confirming that transaction. And it's gone. Hackers, just die. Okay, guys, I hope this was informative. Of course, never give away your private keys. I tell everybody, keep them safe. It is your private key. Do not share with anybody. If you do share your private key and they steal your funds and you have a lot of money invested in the smart contract of your choice, this is a way to keep your funds safe. Okay, guys, I hope you understand it. As you can see, this transaction cannot be sent. I have changed the owner of this wallet. This wallet is compromised. This wallet is stolen by somebody else. What have I done? I have made a new wallet, and this wallet has been made a boss over this wallet. Let's just check it. As you can see, the transaction is still not coming through. This transaction will not be confirmed until I confirm it on my telephone with my other wallet. This protects you against hackers. If somebody has the access to your private key, in this way, your a hacker cannot steal your funds. Why not? You have created a second wallet that is the boss of your wallet. So it doesn't matter if your funds get sent. You must really accept it. I hope this is clear, guys. This was the first part.